My topic is digital apps, mHealth in type 1 diabetes. And I'm not going to talk any theory. I'm just going to talk about a few of such apps which are useful in clinical practice. So the role of apps in diabetes is becoming more significant. And I've got five just short headings. One is I'll introduce the topic. I'll go on to the diet app. I'll look at a monitoring app. I'll look at a hypoglycemia app. And I'll look at a psychosocial aspect app. Most of these apps are for type 1 diabetes, but some of the cases and the examples I've shown are for type 2 diabetes, but it has got a similar impact on type 1 diabetes as well. So this is, you know, the Dexcom machine, which is a small CGM, a small sensor, which is attached to the Dexcom reader, and you can check your blood sugars many times a day. So this is a 45-year-old gentleman. HbA1c is 5.4. Normal blood glucose levels. His levels are tightly controlled, and you can see that in the Dexcom, you have an app. Dexcom is a new generation CGM, but this is a particular example is that of a slightly older generation, because the gentleman in question was 45 years then, and you can get your blood glucose levels on the app on a watch. And this is just to show you the green color is the time in range and the pink color is hypoglycemia. The yellow color is hyperglycemia. And you can see each time the blood glucose levels go up, it's tightly brought down, except for one particular day in the evening, night at about 11 p.m. when the blood glucose went up. And on that day, when the blood glucose went up, the person had a very stressful event. In fact, he watched an IPL match, and therefore, the stress of watching an IPL match led to the secretion of cortisol, which increased hunger. And he went to the refrigerator and opened the rasgulla and ate not only the rasgulla, but the sugary liquid within the rasgulla. How do I know that? So I had given it away by saying that the gentleman was only 45 years at that time. He didn't have diabetes. So this is my own CGM. Of course, my name is there on the picture. It's my own CGM. I wore it when Dexcom was initially coming to India. So many years back, I'm 51 now. So this is almost 6-7 years ago. And you can see how technology helps and how in a non-diabetic person, the blood glucose is controlled. But even in a non-diabetic person or not a person not known to have diabetes, you can see an occasional stressful event like all human beings, diabetologists and endocrinologists are also subject to the same temptations as other people are. So you can see what the rasgulla liquid did to my blood sugar levels. It touched about 140 at that time. And ever since I've been very cautious about eating sweets, especially at night. So after having said that, let me go on to the diet issue, which is very important. I'm aware that time is short, so I will quickly cover my topic. So this is a app called the MyFitnessPal. It's a free app which anybody can use. Now, again, this is a reading which I took just for the purpose of this presentation. So you can see that I've spent about 1,710 calories. If I add my food to it, I've also done about 171 calories of exercise. So what I have to do is I have to eat enough food to cover these calories. So I have about 1,881 calories remaining. So I've already finished the day. So I'm entering the data retrospectively of my breakfast, my lunch, and my dinner. So let's see my breakfast. You can see my breakfast, which is, you can choose Indian foods. As you can see, there's a lot of foods out there. Let me choose dosa. Well, I ate two dosas, but I'm going to put that I ate only one because just I wanted to show you that it shows the calories, it shows the carb count, it shows the fat content, it shows the protein content. And this is a very, very simple app which anybody can use. And the best thing is it's free. Of course, if you go for the premium version, it is expensive, but I have been using this app for like 6-7 years and I haven't felt the need for a premium version because carb counting is. So it also tells you what kind of food, like it says that the dosa may have saturated fat. Now let's continue to look at the other foods that can be entered in this app. You can see now my lunch being entered, the chapati, 1,120 calories and the carbs mentioned there. You can see the dal. You can even give it as 0.4 cups or 0.5 cups, and exact measurement is given. You will know the carb content of that. You can see koshimbir, which is a very local food, which is extremely good and healthy. You can also see the curd. Yes, I don't eat curd rice, though I'm a South Indian, I eat curd here. And you can also see the other foods being entered, all the Indian foods. So this is a dinner being entered. So it's a very simple app. Anybody can use it. And as you can see now, I've entered. Let me go back to that slide part where I show you the carbs. And now I'm entering. You can see that my calorie content is quickly filling up. Veg pulao at night, 530 calories. And you can cut down the serving to an appropriate serving. If you've taken only half a cup, you can even, as you can see in the screen, you can just put, you know, one third of a cup or half a cup. And that also can be entered. It gives you the carb count, 24 grams of carbs in that. And you can see I still have some calories remaining. Remember, I actually underreported the dosas. And I've reported only one snack, which is a sandwich. So I've got about 1,000 calories remaining now to take. Let me confess that I took a papaya. And then you can see this. It mentions papaya has lots of vitamin C. And now my diary, I think, is complete. So I'm going to click on complete the diary. I've completed the diary now. And once I completed the diary, it's telling me you've not eaten enough. Sometimes that happens. You've not eaten enough. So you may need to eat more. And you can see the weight being tagged. So it's a very elegant app, very easy to use. And the most important thing, it's free. So carb counting is very simple. Of course, you can't take photos and put it up and understand that feature is going to come. And of course, there are some very premium features. But at one look, this app can tell you how much carbs you're eating a day. Like the screen shows, how much is the carbs you're eating, how much is the protein, how much is the fat. But if you want to see the foods highest in carbs that you've eaten, you'll have to unlock the premium version. But as I showed you, I've shown you veg pulao. So probably that's the one had the maximum number of carbs. And I didn't eat a rasgulla on this occasion. So that's why, you know, the pulao is a major one. So we've looked at a diet app, the MyFitnessPal app, which is a very simple app. Let's look at the monitoring. So this is a patient with diabetes and pregnancy, and you can see the difficulties in monitoring. You can see 62, the blood sugar comes down to 62. She has a biscuit, and then she has a biscuit again, and she's got a lot of readings. It's very difficult to look at it and make sense of it. So for that, you have a very simple app called One Touch Reveal app, which is available, but now almost many glucometers offer this sort of facility, where once a glucometer blood sugar is checked, it syncs to the mobile phone, syncs to the cloud, and you can see the results yourself. So you also have something called time in range, so which is not possible for everybody. You know, India is a country where cost is a big issue, but you can get something called point in range in green color, the number of readings which are within normal. So that's an innovation where people who can't afford to be on CGM all the time, the type ones, they can even get their point in range. And this is a time course of this lady. You can see this lady had asthma, and you can see the blood glucose levels rose. This gives you the date on which the blood glucose levels rose, the x-axis, and you can see this is on 12th and 13th of September. And on this day, you can see which time the blood glucose levels rose. So in the bottom panel, the top panel shows you the days on which the blood glucose rose. The bottom panel shows you the time at which it rose. And it's a very clear, it's the postprandial increase after breakfast and after dinner. There's really no increase after lunch. So we've got our diabetes educated and the asthma got treated. The asthma got treated and the sugar levels normalized, and the diabetes educator brought back the prandial sugars into normal. So this is to show you that this very simple app, which comes nowadays free with many glucometers, I don't have to tell the name, almost every glucometer of the major companies come with free apps, which give you the readings, the time in range, and it's good to shift to that. CGM is not needed for everybody. Now, let me look at the next issue. So I've looked at introducing, I showed you my own CGM reading. I've shown you the diet issue. I showed you the MyFitnessPal app, which is a free app for measuring diet. Let's look at the monitoring issue, which I showed you. Instead of writing down the blood glucose levels, you know, the glucometer can sync to a mobile phone, and that data is there forever, and your doctor can see it, your diabetes educator can see it, you can look at trends, you can understand, people with diabetes can understand when their sugar goes up. Let's look at the hypoglycemia issue. Now, this is one of my patients who was wearing the Medtronic Guardian Connect, which is a continuous glucose sensor and a real-time sensor which gives alarms. So you can see that the blood sugar is 137. This is at 12:37 p.m. and again 137 at 12:37 p.m. on the same day. But what is important is this is a 12-hour view and this is a 24-hour view. What you will see in the middle panel in the 24-hour view is that there was hypoglycemia which enabled the patient to take a snack. And the person took a snack, the blood glucose level started going up. So this lady was on a basal insulin as well as bolus insulin. And you can see the hypoglycemia being detected. So there's an alarm showing high or low glucose. It's showing high because this is retrospective data and this is the present situation. So the important thing is that there are some problems with this. One is that too many alarms can cause what is called alarm fatigue and anxiety. So I don't think it's a good idea to switch on all these alarms, but it's a good idea to keep looking at your sugars if you have type 1 diabetes and if you can afford this kind of technology. And you will see that at 12:47, the blood glucose has come from 137 to 125. You can see this is rapidly falling. Why I show you this slide is that you can see the rapid fall in glucose. Supposing you do a glucometer test and it's 125. Well, 125 isn't high or low. So you would pass it off as a very good sugar. But when you see that in the last hour, 24 hours or 12 hours or so, it has been showing a steady decline. You would like to watch it for some more time because studies have shown that if the blood glucose levels are running low for 48 hours on a downward trend, that predicts a severe hypoglycemia requiring assistance. So this sort of a situation will call for you to down titrate your insulin doses or at least adjust your diet. So this is a kind of freedom that a real-time glucose sensor gives you. And of course, the newer real-time glucose sensors are connected to a pump. So that's the issue. So I've introduced the topic. I've introduced the topic of technology by showing you how nowadays you can get your CGM readings on a phone or on a watch or an app. And that reading can give you insights into the sugar levels, just as I showed you the sweet spiked the blood glucose levels. I showed you the MyFitnessPal, which has almost all the Indian foods. In fact, it can differentiate between a chapati taken in a hotel and a homemade chapati. So that kind of difference is there. It's free app. I looked at the monitoring issue where you can take away the drudgery of monitoring simply by using a simple app which is connected to a glucometer and give you the point and range, because the time and range is good for CMEs and talks. But in real life practice, India is a country where the sheer magnificence of diabetes coexists with ground realities like affordability and availability. I don't have to talk about this to doctors like Dr. Debashish, Dr. Banshee, Dr. Deepak Dalal, Dr. Archana, who are doing some excellent work in type 1 diabetes. So let me go on to the final part of my presentation, which is a psychosocial aspect. I think the psychosocial aspect is very important and underrated in type 1 diabetes, especially during the pandemic. People are at home, people are worried, people don't know what to do, their sugars are high, they're spiking fever, they are emotionally drained, they're depressed, they don't sleep at night. So lots of emotional requirements. And unfortunately, artificial intelligence cannot give empathy. An artificial intelligence or an app can tell you, if you tell the app, for example, that I'm feeling tired, the app will tell you, get up and exercise. Exercise gives endorphins. If you app may ask you, how is your day? And you tell the app that your day was good or bad. The app cannot feel for you. That feeling has to come from a human being. And that's why you need to merge technology with a real life human being. And that's, I want to just highlight the Blue Circle Foundations app, which is again a free app, which we at the Chalaram Diabetes Institute have also collaborated with them to see how things work. I think this app isn't opening. Let me try to open it. Yes. So So you can see that this is a Blue Circle app which works very well. So this is a project which we have done with the Blue Circle app called Blue Circle Buddy. It's a free 24-hour psychosocial helpline for people with type 1 diabetes conducted by people with type 1 diabetes. So it is an app for diabetes, by people with diabetes. And we as doctors have done, the doctors and the faculty at Chelaram Diabetes Institute have trained, and some of them have gone through our online diabetes educators course. And some of them, these type 1 diabetes people, have taken on the responsibility of helping out other people with type 1 diabetes. And also the Mental Health Institute, Dr. Soumitra Pathare, is also involved in this project, who's guided them on the psychosocial counseling, and we've guided them on the medical counseling. So in that sense, this is a project, a collaboration between the Blue Circle Foundation and the Chelaram Diabetes Institute and the Mental Health Institute in Mumbai, Dr. Soumitra. And this is working very successfully. So this app has got lots of other things also. You can download your records. The Buddy project is there. We partnered with the Blue Circle Foundation for a vaccination drive, because people with diabetes are at risk of COVID and we wanted to help them. So we partnered for a vaccination drive at the Chelaram Diabetes Institute. There are calculators for insulin, carb ratios, correction factors. You can donate. There's very good nutritional info. And the best thing is that this app is free. And this is, of course, run by Dr. Nupur Lalwani, who is very committed, leads a committed group of professionals with type 1 diabetes, who are not professionals in diabetes, but who have type 1 diabetes and professionals in their own right. So this is the Stevia Modak, which are recipes uploaded by the people in the group who are actually helping this group to come up. And you can see that there are Western foods also. You can see this particular pasta. Many of these are uploaded by people with diabetes as well as doctors and nutritionists. And you can also see certain other information, like you can say type in bread, for example. Once you type in bread, you see different kinds of bread, commercial bread, see the carb content of the breads. And then you can go ahead, and this is also important. You can see the insulin carb ratio. You can do the correction factors. You can enter the total daily dose of insulin, the bolus insulin. There are also tools for people with, you're using CGMs and pumps. So this is a very good free app to use for people with type 1 diabetes. And we at Chelaram Diabetes Institute are very proud to partner with this app. And the best feature of it all, in my opinion, is a final feature, which I showed you, is that people with diabetes can actually suggest to them what they want to see. And this app continuously redefines itself for improving the lives of people with diabetes. So in that sense, this app has got a lot of potential even in the future days to come. So thank you. It's been a real pleasure talking to you. I have not shown any theory, but I've just shown you some apps which everybody can use. My presentation was very simple, but I really enjoy talking about type 1 diabetes, because I really think it's time to do a lot of good work for people with type 1 diabetes. And this is possible today. Once more, grateful for this opportunity to be with all of you. And it's a pleasure being here.